Good afternoon. Can I remind members that social distancing measures are in place in the Chamber and across the Holyrood campus, and I ask that members take care to observe these measures, including when entering and exiting the Chamber, and please only use the aisles and walkways to access your seat and when moving around the Chamber. The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Canon David Richards, the Rector of St Paul's and St George's Church in Edinburgh.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. When white Europeans arrived on the island of Hawaii, the locals called them Haole, H-A-O-L-E. It literally means no breath. One Indigenous Hawaiian explained it like this. The settlers, they said, were always in a hurry to build plantations, harbours and ranches. They always seemed out of breath. I have a question for you this afternoon. What patterns or rhythms of life do you have that renew and sustain you, that give you the chance to draw breath? It's been said that the hardest person you will ever lead is probably yourself. Former UK chair of the International Stress Management Association observed this about the person of Jesus Christ. Jesus taught and practiced self-awareness. Jesus responded rather than reacted to whatever happened. His ability to respond, his response ability, was strong. And it is fascinating to see how Jesus sustained his life. He didn't spend all his time praying or reading the scriptures. He didn't spend all his time alone in quiet and solitude or performing miracles or preaching. He did those things, but he did other things as well. He had a group of really close friends that he spent time with and laughed with. He regularly went to corporate worship, went to the synagogue and the temple. Imagine being the Son of God and having to listen to other people's sermons. He enjoyed creation, long walks and exercise. He welcomed small children and listened to them. He enjoyed meals and parties, especially with non-religious people. If we don't tend our souls, then we end up with what one psychologist has called ego depletion, a level of fatigue that goes beyond mere physical tiredness. Depleted people will feel sad more easily and are more likely to make poor choices. Physiologically, an area of our brain, the anterior cingulate cortex, actually experiences slowing down. How do you know if your soul is weary? Well, small things irritate you more than usual. You find it more difficult to make decisions. The temptation to eat more, drink more alcohol, or to give in to particular cravings is harder to resist. Simply, you have less courage. There's a famous quote, "Fatigue makes cowards of us all." The people of Scotland need you to be healthy, to have patterns of life that sustain and renew you, so you can make good, brave decisions and be the leaders we need you to be. A Sabbath, whenever you might practice it, is the time to transition, it's been said, from human doings to human beings. My prayer for you is that you find that rhythm of life, a rhythm that gives you chance for breath and to find rest for your souls.
Thank you. Thank you very much. The next item of